Hey there! Today on HBI Guys Workshop, I'm going to show you how to take this glossy cardstock souvenir Goonies map and turn it into something that actually looks like a real Goonies map from the movie. Through weathering and other techniques, I can show you how to make a map just like this. So come on over to the paint area and follow along. All right, well, we're over in my paint and prep area of HBI Guys Workshop, and I've got laid out pretty much everything you're going to need to do this project, except for one thing. And the one thing is I've got a can over here warming up in some hot water, and that is Tester's Dull Coat. Tester's Dull Coat product to give us a flat sheen. Now, the first thing you want to do with this glossy cardstock kind of a map is you want to abuse it. You want to beat it up. This thing is way too shiny and way too nice the way it comes. It's a very nice looking map, and it's about the right size and everything, so it's a very good starting point. You don't have to try to freehand draw anything and all that. But it's in way too nice a shape, and it doesn't even have holes. It has printed on black spots. So you want to abuse it. You want to, you know, put this in your back pocket, roll it up. You can't be too nice to it. You know, you've got to understand, this is a beat-up map. Remember the movie 1632, all right? That's how old it is. And the movie was filmed in about 85. So you want to beat the absolute heck out of it, okay? Now, the other things, that's just your surface prep. You know, that's just beating up this map, scrunching it up, unfolding it, rolling it out so you get, you know, pretty much so that it stays flat on its own. And you know, like I said, roll it up, stick it in your back pocket, and go for a walk. Drop it in a snowbank. You know, let it dry out. It's kind of glossy cardstock, so you really can't hurt it too much. Now, you can find these anywhere online. Just search Goonies map, and you don't have to pay those insane prices that people charge to weather a map as if it was, you know, the Goonies map. If you just want something that's going to look nice in a frame or a shadow box for your home, then all you need to do is pick these up. You can usually get these for less than $10 shipped to your door once you find a source for them. And that I'm going to leave up to you to find your source for these maps. Just Google Goonies maps, and eventually you'll come up with it. You'll find out where I'm getting them from, and you'll be able to buy them for yourself and weather them up and beat them up. Now, the other things I use, a cheap paint palette, a really, really cheap paintbrush. These are, you know, you get 25 of these for a buck at the dollar store. Some Windex. Doesn't matter the brand name, windshield washer, blue, whatever. I use craft paints. Now, the colors are completely up to you, what you want to use. But I like to keep it really, really simple. I use raw umber and Tuscan red. And, you know, you're looking at not even $2 worth of paint right there. And a propane torch. Disclaimer, if you decide to use a propane torch to do some of the weathering, I am not responsible if you're an idiot and you burn down your house. I have nothing to do with that. I'm not telling you to do it this way. I'm just saying this is how I do it and how I get my results. You burn down your home or your apartment or your garage, that's 100% on you. It's not my fault that you're an idiot. I use some old rags. I like to use old socks. Old socks are some of my best rags to use. And Tester's Dull Coat. You're going to want to seal this with something so that you don't ruin anything on there. And you also want to be able to contain your weathering when you're all done. So I'm going to put the torch and everything on the side. We're going to move everything out of the way, because the first thing we're going to do with this nice warm can of Dull Coat is we're going to give a nice little spray job. Now, this doesn't have to be perfect. Remember, this is a map that's been beat to hell. It's been around the world. It somehow ended up in Astoria for the Goonies. And so we're not going for a show finish here on a military model or a car model. But just give it a coat. And that's going to relax the map quite a bit too. So some of your cracks and creases are just going to disappear. Yes, I spray right on my table. That's the whole point of this table. And that's it. That's all we need to do for the spray is give it one coat. Now, I'm going to let that dry, and then I'm going to come back and show you guys how I do my weathering. Okay, so the Dull Coat lacquer is dried. It doesn't take long at all. It is a lacquer, and you can see that it's lost some of its shininess. You know, and that's going to help the next thing adhere to it. To dry it up a little faster, I just use a regular heat gun that you'd use on model airplanes, but you can just let it sit and dry. Otherwise, you can dry it yourself. Now, what I've done here that you can see on the screen that I moved out is this little paint palette. And I've taken the raw umber and a mix of the Windex, and they're mixed at about 10 to 1. There's not much paint in it at all. There's actually just a lot of the Windex in there. And I want that really thin, really watery. And then you can just take a rag or a towel, like I showed you, balled up, and you'll just dip it in it, and you're going to put it all over the mat. And I'm working over an old shirt because it tends to get kind of dirty. Now, you can get this as dirty as you want. Remember, this map has been around for a very long time. You can see that it's soaking into the paper, yet because of the Del Coat, it shouldn't weaken the paper or anything underneath here. So I'm just going to keep using it. I'm going to keep dabbing it on. More paint in some areas, less paint in others. I mean, you're using maybe a dollop size of paint about your thumbnail. And then we're going to go and rub that all in. Real nice. You see those creases where you beat the heck out of this sticking up? Okay, that's what you want. That's what you want to see. You want to see that starting to darken and kind of looks like hell, you know? Now, acrylic paints dry pretty quick, but I'm going to hit it with the heat gun, and that helps dry those up much, much faster. That's just what I want to do, is I want to get a little bit drying, but I don't want to go too far. That's all I want to do for the drying. Now, I'm going to take a different rag that wasn't soaked in the paint, and I'm just going to, now, not completely, I'm not scouring this clean. I'm just spreading out the wash, the actual staining. And see, but I'm not taking a lot of it off. I'm just kind of brushing it off, and look at that. Almost right away, that starts to take the sheen of the other map I showed you. Now, I'm gonna let this dry, and I'm gonna apply two or three more coats, okay? Then, when the coats are done, I'll take an X-Acto knife, and I'll cut out the holes that were just printed on the map. I'll actually cut them out, but I want to wait till the paper's hardened up again, because right now it's quite soft from the spraying or the smattering of all the raw umber wash. I'm going to put a couple more washes into it, let it dry, heat it up with the heat gun, let it dry, and I'll come back once I've done my couple coats. All right, well, another step is done. I've got a couple coats of weathering on there, and that was just simple coats of paint. Now, you can mix and match paints. You can use all one color. That's completely up to you. No one can tell you exactly what's perfect for your map. But as you can see, that it's really starting to take on a beat up, worn look to it. It also, when you start getting all the paint into it, it starts to kind of crinkle up the paper and make it look older. It's been beat up. Obviously, it's been weathered, what they call weathered. Now, here comes the fun part. And again, the disclaimer. If you burn your house down or you choose to copy my methods, not my fault. You're the one that's choosing to play with fire. I'm just showing you how I did it because I know I'm not going to burn my home down. Now, what I have here is a standard propane torch. And the reason I like to use this instead of a match or a candle, which is something you can use, is that it stands all by itself. And I don't have to try to hold an open flame while I'm trying to weather the paper. Now, what we're going to do is I want to weather all the way around the edge. You can see the way it's printed, they have a fake darker burned edge on it. But I want it to be real. Also, when the torch hits the paper, because it's a glossier style paper, or it's a thicker style paper, it will actually start to make it age and thicken up and kind of bubble in spots, and that's exactly what we want, because they would have been writing this on parchment or an animal skin, and that's the look that we want for it. So let me fire up the torch here. Alright, so we don't need much of a flame. I mean, just barely. You can just barely hear it squealing out of there. And we're going to set it up, and I'm going to tilt the camera up so that you can see the flame. Now, all you need to do, and I'm going to do it from the reverse side, okay? So that I can burn the front easier. Now, when the paper starts to actually ignite, blow it out, okay? Don't be dumb. But all you need to do is run it along the edge and the paper will start to bubble, but it really won't burn if you move fast enough. Okay? And you just continue weathering that. And you can see, I'm not weathering the back of this map because I have something special planned for it. But you can see, it starts to look like a real burned map. And you'll continue working all your edges. You'll work through your holes here. And you'll continue working around your edges with your torch or your match until you get a nice, crisp, burnt edge. I'm going to keep working on this and come back when I'm all done. All right, well, I've had my fun. I've gone at it with the blowtorch. As you can see, it really starts to stiffen up the paper, make it like parchment. It also looks much cooler than the original edge that was on the paper. Now, there is no wrong or right way to do this. Just keep going over it with your match or your soldering blowtorch or whatever you choose to burn that edge, as long as you don't destroy your entire map. You can see it gives it this really uneven texture now. Like, it's really been around a long time, like it was made out of animal skin or parchment. So it starts to look nice. No map is going to look the same. That's the great part about doing this, is that when you make one or your friend makes one, none of them are going to look the same. Everybody's is going to look a little bit different. Now, there's one final step that I want to do, and I can do it on camera, and then your map's going to be ready to display. When I get done with these, I don't seal them with anything. I want them to stay rough and uneven and beat up, so I don't seal them with any, like, a dull coat or anything like that, because these are either going to be framed or they're going to be pinned to a wall or kept on a desk or something. They're not going to be, you know, you can handle this. You can rub your fingers off. Acrylic paint's not going to come off unless you get it wet again. So if you don't plan on getting it wet again, you really don't have to worry. Now, all you need to do is just take a little bit of that Tuscan Red, that craft paint that I showed you earlier. And that's the color I prefer. And all you have to do is just get some on the paintbrush. And, see those drips? We'll get some more and we'll go, I missed it entirely. This is the fun part. This is even more fun than a blowtorch. But, like that. Now, look at that. See, now that is just enough for me. I've got a long blood spatter and a short one and a little streak. Now, you can go really crazy and cover it with a lot of blood, or you can just leave it like that. Now, that's good enough for me. I don't think there needs to be a lot on there. Just as a little indication that it was a pirate map. Clean up my work table there. So you don't want to do it on the kitchen table. The wife will kill you. But that's good enough for me. Now, we're done. All you would need to do, if you want to actually roll this up or use it, would be to poke a hole here and put on a little leather lanyard like they did in the movie so that Mikey could roll it up. But I'm going to display mine open at all times with this surface facing out with a little bit of a blood splatter on it. So I'm not going to need anything like that. I appreciate you guys watching. Feel free to try this technique out on your own. You can use this with any old map or paper to make it look old. It's really a lot of fun to do. It doesn't take long at all. And when you get done, you have something that you've completely made yourself, completely unique. And, you know, from the Goonies never say die. HBI Guys Workshop, I appreciate you watching this on how to make a Goonies map. Subscribe, leave your comments in the sections below. Thanks again.